Hello everyone, I'm Arjun Srinivasan. I'm a member of the Tableau Research Group in Seattle, and today I'll be talking about an online study and corpus of natural language utterances for specifying data visualizations. This presentation is based on work I did back as a PhD student at Georgia Tech, along with Nikhila Nyapathy and John Stasko, as well as Bongshan Lee and Stephen Drucker from Microsoft Research. So over the past few years, there's been a growing amount of interest in natural language interfaces, both within research and commercial tools in the context of data visualization. And while these systems have gotten better at understanding different types of utterances and even training end users on how they can overcome system limitations through features like autocomplete, we still lack an empirical understanding of what type of utterances people naturally tend to specify visualizations with. And it's important for us to gain a better understanding of this, as it can help us assess the progress that we've made in terms of system development. But also more importantly, it can help us support and design more natural user experiences going forward. So to this end, we conducted an online study to collect a corpus of utterances that people use to specify some popular data visualizations. For each session, we randomly assigned participants to one of three tabular data sets and then presented them with 10 visualizations made using that data set in a random order. In terms of the chart types, we covered a range of popular visualizations for tabular data, including bar charts, line charts, scatter plots, some variations of these that covered 1 to 3 attributes at a time. For each trial, we showed participants a preview of the data set as well as the chart, and then ask them to enter one or more utterances that they would use to specify the displayed chart. And you can see the study interface on your screens now. We shared the study on a number of channels, including mailing lists at universities, within Microsoft, as well as some visualization-focused groups on social platforms like LinkedIn and Reddit. 102 people participated in the study, and through these sessions, we collected a total of 893 utterances across the three data sets that we had. There were about 89 utterances per chart type, and individual utterance lengths varied between 1 all the way up to 38 words, with an average of 9 words per utterance. Now, just to give a glimpse of the collected data, here are some utterances that we collected from the study. So to characterize these utterances, we looked at them from two kind of major dimensions. The first one is what information an utterance contained, and the second one is how the utterance was phrased. So for the first dimension, utterances typically included a set of different kind of references to data attributes, and these included things like explicit references to the actual attribute string, semantic references through words like way instead of weight or fuel economy instead of MPG, as well as value-based references where the column or the attribute was referred to using data items or rows. Alternatively, some utterances even explicitly listed the chart type or some encoding channels, or included references to aggregation functions like average, mean, sum, count, and so on. And in some specific cases, the utterances even contained references to sort of design choices that participants wanted to instill into the chart. For the second dimension of utterance phrasings, we observed three high-level patterns, including commands that were phrased as requests to the system, queries that were comparable to keyword-based searches, and finally, data-driven questions that participants expected to see the chart as a response to. And I encourage you to look at the paper to find more details about this categorization as well as the distribution of utterances across them. Based on this characterization, we also discussed some design implications, including how systems should try to accommodate more natural user phrasings instead of making users adjust to what the systems can understand, how we need to support variations in attribute references, as well as how systems need to continue implicitly inferring visual encodings, but also give users control over how they specify encodings manually. To support future work, we've also made this utterance dataset freely available and discussed a couple of ways to use it to evaluate current systems as well as build new ones. And with that being said, I thank you all for tuning in, and I'd be happy to take any questions. Thank you.